Your Excellency, Bishop Jesus Cabrera, Bishop Emeritus of Alaminos, Your Excellency, Bishop Fidelis Layug, Auxiliary Bishop and Apostolic Administrator of Alaminos, the Reverend Fathers, the Reverend Deacons, the Religious Sisters and Brothers, my dear Seminarians, Brothers and Sisters in Christ, and you, beloved brothers in the priesthood. Mandaragup tayo lamet, yaman silibra, nakarakpan tan misteryo, na inkapari tayo. Sa kaya grasyan ag nasukat so inkapari tayo. A grace that surpasses worthiness. A grace that can only be understood in heaven. Nothing and nobody on earth can explain in adequate terms what the priesthood is. It is a gift in mystery. Sakay yan in pangaron misteryo. Today, our Christian Mass and the renewal of our priestly promises happen only a few weeks from the national elections. To vote is a patriotic duty as much as a holy duty. We are citizens of the Republic and citizens of heaven. We were not born priests. We were born infant boys. Our birth led us to another rebirth in baptism. That rebirth in baptism led us to the table of the Lord. That communion in the Eucharist reached its full bloom when we were sealed with the Holy Spirit at confirmation. Can a mother forget her infant, be without tenderness for the child of her womb? Even should she forget, I will never forget you. See, upon the palms of my hands, I have engraved you. Hindi natin inilaglag ang ating pagka-Pilipino noong tayo ay ordinan. Ang totoo, inordinan din ang ating pagka-Pilipino. Ang ating kabuuan ay inordinan. Lahat-lahat sa atin ay inordinan. Ang pansamantalang buhay natin ngayon at ang buhay na walang hanggan sa kabila, lahat-lahat sa atin. Bait at bisyo, madilim na kalooban at magandang mukha, buong-buo lahat-lahat, sa ating ordinasyon, bawat buto, bawat patak ng dugo, bawat kalamnan at ugat ay naging pari din. Ang DNA natin ay may tatak pari. Papari tayo, tan paparin Pilipino. Sa inkapari tayo, asingasay inka-Pilipino tayo. So masyansya ang gadbiek na bilay. Ang gadlampas na pate, papari tayo, et adianga. Tansika tayo, metso Pilipino, et adiangaan. Because we are priests, we are called men of God. A man of God must also be a good man of the motherland. We are all pro Deo et patria. Love of country is one of the forms of showing love for God. Our country, our citizenship is God's gift to us. We must be good stewards of this motherland and stewards of Mother Church. Pro Deo et patria. Repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar and to God what belongs to God. But Caesar and God are not co-equal because Caesar is from God and will account before God in due time. Our critics and those who do not understand what being a priest means want us to stay confined with cult and worship. They like the smell of incense, but not the odor of inhuman poverty. They want the sight of candles lit in churches, but they want us to ignore the gunfire against the innocent. They want us to say that Jesus is the truth, but they want us to keep quiet about the lies in the cyberspace. They want us to feed the poor, but they get angry when we ask why are they poor. They want us to decorate the churches, but they want us to keep quiet when the imprint of God is defaced among His children. Hindi mangyayari, hindi dapat mangyari, hindi tayo susuko. Bawal ang paring duwag. At ilan sa mga Pariseo na mula sa karamihan ay nangagsabi sa kanya, Guru, sawayin mo ang iyong mga alagad. At sumagot siya at nagsabi, Sinasabi ko sa inyo, kung hindi mangagsisiimik ang mga ito, ang mga bato ay sisigaw. We claim as our own the declaration of St. Oscar Romero. We do not want to be an anti against anybody. We simply want to be the builder of a great affirmation, the affirmation of God who loves us and who wants to save us. That is who we are. This is who we are. We are priests, yes, but we are Filipinos too, willing to live and die for God and country. Those who hear us speak against the misuse of power in society, those who hear us challenge the unbridled use of public money, those who get angry when we condemn vote buying, those who find nothing wrong with killing the poor, have sighed in exasperation about us. Will nobody rid me of this troublesome priest? That is what King Henry said of Thomas à Becket. That is what the knights of the king heard. That is what drove the knights to hack the head of the archbishop. His brain became red with blood, and his blood became white mixed with his splattered brain. For God and for country, I will lay down my life, pro Deo et patria. In every step we take, in every project we begin, in every dream we pursue, in every statement we make, our starting point is Christ. The economists begin with money in mind. The politicians begin with civil power as goal. Builders begin from the architect's design. Priests, our starting point is Christ. Only Christ, always Christ. If politics is without Christ, we must bring Christ there. Do not worry. God cannot be damaged and blasphemed when we bring Him to politics. On the other hand, politics will be very dirty and sinful if we do not lay politics before the feet of Christ the King. Our goal is not victory in the elections. That is too short-sighted, myopic. Our goal is to bring godliness to governance, believing that godly governance will bring us closer to the plan of God. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Manalo o matalo sa bilangan, panalo tayo kung nanindigan tayo para kay Kristo. Si Kristo sa manuman rason tayo na social engagement. Wala tayo't politika aliwan, lapod pakayari tan impluensya. Naingin lapod ibanghilisasyon na politika. Nakaukulay kilalaban sa politika, jet panameglay ng Kristo. Aliwa tayon kingmakers, si katayoy aripen ng Kriston ari. Our only gift for social engagement is Christ. We are not strategists. We are not tacticians. We are not managers. We cannot command our flock to vote like us. Our vote counts only as one. But when that one vote is cast for Christ, we are on the winning side. Our goal and target for social engagement is Christ. We will rebuke as we support. We will commend as we reject. We will heal as ministers, as we denounce as prophets. That is what Christ in politics means. That is what a prodeo et patria priesthood means. Sa ating muling pangangako ng sinumpaan noong tayo ay ordinan, ilang sandali mula ngayon, ibulong din natin ang tahimik ang ating panatang makabayan. Iniibig ko ang Pilipinas, ang aking lupang sinilangan, tahanan ng aking lahi. Tutuparin ko ang mga tungkulin ng isang mamamayang makabayan ng buong katapatan. Iaalay ko ang aking buhay, pangarap at pagsisikap sa bansang Pilipinas. We have in our veins the heroism of Father Mariano Gomez, Father Jose Burgos, and Father Jacinto Zamora. In faith, we carry the priestly spirit of St. Thomas a Becket and St. Oscar Romero. And me, how can I betray the lessons dear Cardinal Jaime Sin taught me? He ordained me. May these holy pastors keep the fire of love aglow, love of God and love of Inang Bayan, Prodeo et Patria. Mabuhay ang paring Pilipino. Viva Kristen Ari.